Hi everyone and welcome to HD Piano. My name is Joanna and in today's lesson we're going to learn how to play Watermark by Anya. So in this part one video I'm going to show you the A section and it sounds like this. Alright, so there you go, and that's the A section. So don't forget to head on over to hdpiano.com where you can check out the remaining two sections to this video. Alright, so Anya, if you don't know, is an Irish musician. And this song is actually written the year that I was born, so in 1988. That gives you a hint of my age. And so, yeah, it's a really beautiful song. And it was a huge hit, this album. I think it was one of her most successful albums. It really launched her career. So, yeah. All right. So, leave below in the comments your other favorite kind of Celtic world music musicians and bands. I'm particularly interested in Celtic music. So, can you leave that below in the comments for me? And I'll go and check those out. All right. Here we go. Let's have a listen to it. We're going to break it down. So, we start down here with this kind of low F. So here's middle C, and we are two Fs below that. And you might have noticed that the left hand is really just arpeggiating each time. So we're just kind of moving up and down the keyboard in the same kind of shapes and the same kind of rhythm. And it's really rubato, this piece. So rubato just means with a lot of feeling. So, you know, you can kind of really manipulate the time. It doesn't have to be very strict. It's very free flowing and expressive. Okay, so we're going to start with this. This is kind of a mini two bar intro. We start down here on this low F. Then we go to C, G, and then our second finger is going to go over to the A, and then we go back down G, and then C. So as you can see, I'm kind of doing this. So you want to try and use the same fingers as I'm using, and you'll use this same finger pattern throughout most of the piece. So we're going to go little finger on F, second finger on C, thumb on G, second finger over to A, G, C. Let's just practice that. And it's just on the eighth note. So it's going one and two and three and one and two and three and. So there's kind of like a, I always think of it like a mountain with each, within each phrase. And in this case, maybe for the first two bars with each chord. So you kind of climb up the mountain. And then as you come down, you can kind of just speed up slightly and then just sort of pause on that last note before you begin the mountain climb again. Does that make sense? So it has that kind of movement within it as well. And that's shaping how I play the chords, and it will help with your rubato kind of expressive feel as well. All right, and so that's just the first two bars. We play it twice through. And so here we go. I'm going to play the intro with a bit of the right hand now as well. So we're going to be up here. Here's the middle C. We're on the top C and the E above that. And it comes in on the last two notes, so I'll show you that. I'm going to use my thumb and my third finger. Do the chord again. Now this time when we play G, we're going to play top C and then C with the E, just like that. So I'm going to play that again. You got it? Okay, that's it. That's literally the speed. You could even go much slower than that. I think the recording is even slower. So, you know, you can really put your own expression into this piece. You can be kind of very interpretive with it. Right, so just one other thing. The pedal, we can hold the pedal the whole time because it's just the same chord. And because it has this kind of this free flowing kind of, I guess like it's called watermark, this one as well. So it's got a kind of a free flowing feel to it. So that pedal can just make everything sort of just the sounds intermingle and go together. So just keep it held down. Okay, into our next bar. We're going to play that chord again with a top F in our right hand. And then here at the end, we go G, F. So I'm just going to play that bar again. Into the next bar, we're going to move to an A minor shape now. So here's the chord. We're going to play A, same kind of shape, A, E, A. Second finger is going to go over to C a little bit higher. And then we play A, A. So I do that again. With the pedal. And again. And the right hand plays this. We've got top E, C with the A. And then we can go down to the A with the low A and the left hand. Does that make sense? I'll do it again. What about my finger numbers? Yeah, I'm going to use my second finger on the top C, thumb on the A there. So you can kind of move your hand position like this rather than going over. All right, let's try that again. So from the A minor. Can you see? I'm going down this A minor chord. Yeah? I'll do it again. So it just comes there right at the end. Okay, we're going to play the F again. We go back to the F shape, just like we did at the beginning. This time we just play a G, and we go back down that A minor chord. And this time it's a bit more even. We've got E, C, and then the A comes in the first A. Does that make sense? Or just play that bar by itself. Okay, so from the beginning again, from the beginning of when we come in with the right hand, here we go. Can you see how it feels like kind of there's like a big tension happening between the change of chords? So there's a bit of a hold and then we launch into the next chord. So try to bear that in mind as you're playing as well. Okay, into the next chord, we're going to go to a B flat chord now. So the left hand does this. So we've got B flat on my little finger, then F, B flat, up to middle C. And I'm going to use my second finger on the middle C. And I'm going to kind of pull out my thumb to the D and then play the B flat. So I'll do that again. Try and follow the finger numbers. And again. Okay, and all I'm doing with my right hand is holding down this top D. Just that. Easy peasy, right? Okay, and then I'm going to move my left hand down. We're going to go to an E flat shape now. I've got E flat, B flat, E flat. Second finger goes over to the G, B flat, G. I'll play that again. Can you see the finger numbers I'm using? A lot of problems in piano can be solved just by using the correct or a kind of a really efficient way of fingering things. Okay, so we're going to go down. We've got D, B flat, G. We're going down this kind of G minor chord here, aren't we? B flat with the E flat. And then a G with the B flat. And again. Got it? All right, and then we go back to the F. with a C in the right hand. Then A. So I'm just going to play those four bars again. From the B flat, are you ready? Okay, we're going to repeat. Little teaser of the B section. So don't forget to head on over to hdpiano.com where you can find the remaining sections to this video. It's been a pleasure to teach you today. My name is Joanna and I look forward to seeing you on hdpiano.com, the home of hybrid piano lessons. Don't forget you can leave a like and a comment below, then I can see what you like. And also you can find us on all social media platforms as well. Well done and see you in the next video.